Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm talking about some potential investments that we can make as we get near the Once to Watch promo that is going to be starting this Friday, October 1st, inside of FIFA 22 Ultimate Team. Yes, Once to Watch promo is coming. I know we've been worried about starting on Ultimate Teams and all this good stuff, but I want to talk about what could be happening on the market with some cards that could get into the Once to Watch promo. Now, of course, there's two different weeks. There's going to be 26 players in total that are in packs for Once to Watch. So I want to talk about that. And also heading into today on Wednesday, kind of just giving you a little market watch and taking a look at where the market is right now. We've seen the market continue to go higher on the meta aspect. A lot of players, new players going extinct today. Ousmane Dembele, Kimpembe. There's a couple other cards. Vinicius Jr. is about to go extinct almost, I think. So I'm talking some of these cards in the market rising up. Maybe it's time to cash out on a couple of these as we look towards a potential dip. In the market heading towards Friday, where a lot of people will be scared with FIFA points being opened with Once to Watches and packs. So I want to talk about that and just kind of give a barometer of the market, of course, a little market watch as well. But first things first, we had new news yesterday on Tuesday from EA Sports. We have not one, not two, not even three, but four Once to Watch cards from PSG. Now, the other three have been confirmed that already are going to be in FIFA, and they confirmed today Sergio Ramos is the fourth Once to Watch card that will be from PSG. Now, in total, we have 10 Once to Watch cards that are confirmed. Konate, Shaqiri's SBC, Wijnaldum, Grealish, Alaba, Hakimi, Lukaku, Cristiano Ronaldo, and Lionel Messi. Now, of course, you add Ramos to that and the Camavinga card that was confirmed. EA Sports tweeted out that Camavinga would be a card that would be involved with Once to Watch. Now, also, this was tweeted yesterday. This is actually Fabrizio Romano. He has some ties with EA Sports, and he released and he showed Camavinga, Andre Silva, and Saul. So technically, we have 12 Once to Watch cards. 12 of the 26 that we know of are already, I guess, released, you could say, or teased. Andre Silva and Saul going to be coming out as Once to Watch cards alongside of all these other ones and Ramos that we know about. So let's talk about the investment side of this. How can we make coins knowing that these cards are going to have Once to Watches? Well, of course, the thing is, when a card does get a Once to Watch item, that means that their gold card goes out of packs. And you've already seen people speculating with this and already seeing people investing in some of these players that are confirmed for Once to Watch. I think a lot of people are investing in Alaba. I think people are buying up Lukaku. And I even think from the news that we had today with Andre Silva and Saul, you're seeing some of their price graphs go up. Take a look at 82 rated Saul, which, by the way, when I saw this guy's rating, when Chelsea released their ratings earlier on a couple weeks ago, I knew that he was getting a Once to Watch because he had a pace upgrade. And you know, with all the other pace downgrades that happened to midfielders and attackers, when I saw an upgrade on this card, I said, man, EA is definitely upgrading the pace on Saul because they want to make his card look a bit more tasty for when they give it a Once to Watch. And again, that was confirmed by Fabrizio today that he will get a Once to Watch. But when that was confirmed, you see his price go from about 1.8K all the way up to 2.4. People went out and invested because they know that this Saul is going to be going out of packs. Now, is this a really good card to invest in? In my opinion, not really. I'm going to show you some cards from last year's Once to Watch and show you how you can maybe think and potentially decide some players that you'd maybe want to buy as an investment as we get towards Friday. Now, the one thing to think about is, again, there's going to be two teams. There's going to be two teams of Once to Watch. So let's say, you know, these players that are shown right now, like Wijnaldum, Grealish, Alaba, Hakimi, not all of these cards are going to be in Team 1, right? There's going to be 11 cards in Team 1. They're going to do a mini release of 3 cards on Sunday. So there's going to be 14 cards until the next Friday. Then they'll do 11 plus 3, and there will be a total of 28 players in Once to Watch, I believe. So it's not confirmed that Ronaldo and Messi will both be in packs day 1. They might do Ronaldo week 1, Messi week 2, or vice versa. There's a little bit of risk because you're not... you're not exactly sure when the card is going to go out of packs, but let me show you how this could work, right? Last year, Allen had a ones to watch card, and I believe it was not released before, you know, Allen was a big transfer into the Prem, but it wasn't confirmed that he was getting a ones to watch. They drop his ones to watch card, and his gold card goes out of packs. Take a look at what happens. Allen gold card goes out of packs on the Friday, October 9th. He goes from 79,000 coins and into the next week with all of the people still building squads, still buying Premier League center defensive mids like this Allen, and still an in-demand card, he rises up to 101,000 coins. Now, there's other sides to this, right? The reason why this gold Allen rose up is because he was not a confirmed ones to watch. A lot of these cards that are already confirmed, their golds probably aren't going to rise up that much because people have already invested in them and have already bought them up, right? What you want to be looking for are cards that transfer this summer that potentially don't have a guaranteed once to watch item coming for them, but that's where the reward is, right? Risk over reward. Now you think about some cards who you would expect to get a once to watch, right? Definitely we're thinking of Sancho. Definitely thinking of Sancho as a card who would potentially get a once to watch. Of course, a big transfer to Manchester United. We know that Ronaldo's getting a once to watch. It just comes down to if another OTW card from Manchester United is going to get released, which I think there will, I think EA would choose Sancho over Varane. Now, they could choose Varane. So Varane or Sancho, whichever one you technically want to quote-unquote invest in, might be a decent buy. I think Sancho, in terms of an investment, would be a much better buy. He's only 30,000 coins compared to Varane being 300K. I know his card doesn't look that amazing, but this is a card that a lot of people on FIFA are excited to use this year because it has new links, right? He is in a new club, new links inside of FIFA for chemistry. He links to Ronaldo, to Bruno Fernandes, to Pogba, to all of those players that a lot of FIFA fans and GGMU fans like to use. That's why I like this Sancho card, right? And he still has really good dribbling. So even though he doesn't have an insane amount of pace, he's got 5-star skills, and he does have 91 dribbling, which probably makes him feel really good in game. He also has that finesse shot trait, which is overpowered this year in FIFA so far. So I like this Sancho card as an investment. I really do. Let's talk about some other ones, right? Romero from Spurs. We don't have a ton of center backs except for Konate and Ramos confirmed yet. I think this could be a card that EA might sneak into ones to watch as a pretty solid card already. You know, it's an in-demand item. He's a lot cheaper as well. If he goes out of packs on Friday, this is like a top five, I would say, Premier League center back in the game of FIFA right now. So I think if he would go out of packs, his gold card would definitely rise up as people use him in their squads, even though he's really cheap. That's a card I would keep a watch on. Sabitzer from the Bundesliga, I think once to watch this year is going to be dominated by the PSG cards, as we already have known. League One, PSG, and the Prem. There's going to be so many Prem cards in once to watch this year. I think that they're going to be sprinkled in from some other cards from other leagues. I think Sabitzer is one of those. He's got a pretty solid card. He's another cheap option that I would keep a look on. Aguero would be one that I would watch. And also Antoine Griezmann. Antoine Griezmann with his transfer back to Atletico Madrid, I think, is another card this year that could be getting a ones to watch. I mean, if they're really starting to hype up this ones to watch promo, and in some of their the launch update pitch notes that EA released, they talked about ones to watch and how it was a huge transfer window, and they want to recognize that in FIFA by putting out some insane content. I think that Griezmann gets a ones to watch this year. I think this is a really, really solid pickup, even based off of the hype. Again, what you're really going to see, and when you make your coins, the profits are going to come if the card that you invest in does actually get into ones to watch. That's the risk in it, right? You're trying to find a card that you think is going to get in ones to watch. Now, a lot of these guys are going to get in. Like last year, a lot of people were buying Allen because they thought he was going to get in. But again, they picked a card that was meta, that was usable, that people would still be buying for their teams, even if he was out of packs. And I would agree that a card like Griezmann, a card like Sabitzer, Romero, and Sancho would all fit that bill this year. So do a little bit more research. Find out some other cards that you think might get into ones to watch, and that could be a potential investment for you. Now, again, if you buy some of these cards, it's going to be a little risky, but you're going to be holding them until the middle of probably next week. Now, if it's a card that does not get in packs, if for a team of the week, for once to watch team one, obviously there are two teams of once to watch this year, just like there was last year. So keep an eye on some cards. Like, let's say Griezmann doesn't get into once to watch team one, but there's still potential he could get in team two. So that could make for another investment opportunity as his card gets supplied and it drops down, but then it maybe goes out of packs the next week, right? So that would be something that I would keep an eye on. As we had two once to watch teams last year, that could be a situation that you see this year as well. So that is what I wanted to talk about first today, is that potential of the ones to watch investment. Now do some more research, find some other transfers, maybe like Victor Osimhen, somebody who transferred. Osimhen transferred last year. He had a ones to watch. But think about some other transfers, you know, to the Serie A maybe, or to the Bundesliga, or to the La Liga even, where, you know, EA is going to have to put in some cards. Just, they can't just do Premier League and League One. So start to do your research again. Remember some of the big transfers that happened this summer. EA likes to, again, choose a lot of high-rated cards and a lot of low-rated cards all in between, to kind of make these ones to watch squads. So just kind of think through that stuff and who you think might be getting a ones to watch, and then invest accordingly if you think that could be something that would happen. So that is definitely an investing method that you can do. Now, when would you buy these cards, right? I think you might, you know, if you, the longer you can hold off, the better technically. Let's say you were to buy somebody like Sancho, the hype is probably going to start to pick up on a card like Sancho, as people think that he's going to get a ones to watch. They're going to start buying him. People have probably already been buying Sanchos as we've been loading up and as we've been gearing up towards ones to watch. But I think you would definitely have to get these buys in before Friday. Now, I know the market is kind of high right now, so maybe you find an opportunity where this card drops a little bit, maybe with some supply at Division Rivals Rewards, which will come early Thursday, or maybe even today with whatever content EA releases. Thursday as well, we have marquee matchups. I think as well as what I'm about to talk about with the market, I think that even on Thursday, as we head into Friday, people might start to sell some cards like we saw last year, because people are afraid of the supply that's going to be coming. So that might be a buy time for some of those items. So that is the ones to watch investment opportunity that I wanted to present you guys with today, so that you can make some informed decisions on that. I might buy a couple ones to watch cards that could go out of packs. We'll see. It's a little bit of a gamble. I might put some coins aside towards it, but we will see. Now let's talk about a few other things, because today is Wednesday, right? And that means team of the week is going to be released. Now I want to take a look at a team of the week prediction with you guys really quick. Now, last week they released the team of the week early. Usually they release the team of the week at 6 p.m. UK, but last week they released it at 4 p.m. UK with the drop of EA Access. Now, I don't know when this team of the week 2 is going to be released. It's either going to be at 4 p.m. UK or 6 p.m. UK, so we're going to have to keep a watch out for that. But I think this prediction from Foothead, looks really accurate. They've got Emile Smith Rowe being the featured team of the week item for his performance against Spurs. I think it's either Smith Rowe or Saka going to get a card from that game. But this team of the week, if this was the actual team of the week that gets released today, looks very, very usable. And I want to talk about a few cards that are in here. Position Chains, Asensio, and Kunku. Leipzig had a huge win over the weekend. Ones to watch Hakimi. He is already confirmed to be having a ones to watch card. Some people think he's getting an inform this week for PSG's game over the weekend. I wonder if EA, if Hakimi gets an inform this week, and right now his gold card is extinct on the market. If Hakimi were to get an inform this week, that would make me wonder if he will not be a part of ones to watch team number one. That would make me think that if they're giving an inform, they want that inform to be out in packs, then they're going to drop the ones to watch. But, you know, that's maybe me reading into it a little bit. I honestly do not know. If he's not in team of the week today, then that's potentially something where we would think, okay, maybe Hakimi is going to be in ones to watch team one and not team two, based off him not being team of the week. So that's going to be one of the interesting things that we do see today. If Teo Hernandez gets an inform, that's going to be a cracked out card. He's going to be basically the best left back in the game, so that's going to be something to watch out for. But the market in general, again, is what I want to talk about, because we've seen a lot of prices continue to go up today. Since we didn't have content yesterday on Wednesday, you've continued to see a lot of prices go up, and I just hit my first ever liquid, seeing it in the top left hand corner, 1 million coins of FIFA 22. That is a dub. I started trading with some icons, and I've been just trading with a lot of stuff. Last night, right after I recorded the video, I went out and I bought I bought, what did I buy last night? I bought a Kessie. I bought a couple other cards that were just too cheap, right? You see that I've been trading with a lot of different items. I bought four Kessies and two Kempembes last night. Now, I sold the Kempembes actually a little bit early, but as we've kind of seen as the trend, some of these cards, like as this video is being posted, some of these cards have actually dropped down a little bit. Like Lukaku was 68K, now he's 65. Lacroix is 41. He had the same movement last night. He went to 46, back to 40, back to 45 today, and is now back at 41. Haaland was over 105. He's now 97. So I'm just kind of keeping an eye on some of these cards this evening as we go from Tuesday night into Wednesday, to see if maybe we can get another, you know, possible investment look here with the same fluctuation that we had last night happening into today. So that's one thing that I'm going to keep a close eye on. Again, it's like a carbon copy. Now he's back to 43, but it's a carbon copy of what happened yesterday. So I'm going to keep watching on this. And again, like I was mentioning, what the thing that I'm a little bit worried about right now, as Teo Hernandez is actually extinct, and I think this has to do with him being potentially in Team of the Week today, watch out for Teo Hernandez and the Hakimi cards. If they're not in Team of the Week, people might sell off their golds and you might see them on the market. That would be an interesting scenario to keep an eye out as well. But really watch out for the potential sell-off that could start today and into tomorrow on Thursday. This is kind of the first warning. I want to talk about it. If you want to sell some cards, we saw this happen last year inside of FIFA 21. You see the card, right? These cards, Conte was 386K on basically today, what would have been Wednesday. And that was a peak for him. He went down to 365 on the full game release and then went up after that, of course, for the weekend leagues. And of course, as you know, a card that a lot of people got coins and upgraded to inside of their clubs. Take a look at Aubameyang. Last year went to 355 on basically today, Wednesday was a peak. He dropped off Thursday and Friday down to 316 and then rose up way after that, of course, after the full game release. So this drop off right here, like we see on Aubameyang from last year, is kind of maybe what I'm expecting to see this year as well, because we saw a drop off heading into Saturday and Sunday as people were worried about card prices and the FIFA points that were coming out on Monday of this week. And then we saw the market really rise up nicely after Monday. I think the same thing's going to happen again. So if you want to take the coins on some cards, especially on the lower tier, guys like Alan St. Maximin, we use this example all the time. I know this card is very overpowered in game, but this card is also 79 rated. Even Lacroix, who we're talking about as a very overpowered card in this game, I'm a little worried about it. I'm a little worried about this card because he is, what, 77 rated or 78 rated? 79 rated for Lacroix. Same thing as St. Maximin. He's going to get supplied a ton on Friday. He's going to get packed a lot, and his price is going to drop 100% guaranteed. Now, it could bounce back, but this is the scenario where it gets interesting. Are you going to sell some of the stuff, try to buy it when it maybe drops a little bit lower on Friday, or are you just going to ride it out? Because as we saw with Aubameyang and Conte, they both went higher from right now where they were on a Wednesday before the full game was released. They both went higher than that point later on, but they dipped and went down in the meantime. So that's kind of a decision that you might have to make, and we're going to talk about that a little bit more tomorrow. But I wanted to talk about the specificity of how I do think some people will start to take the coins, and it might not be a terrible idea to take the coins on some cards that you have seen explode up in price in the past couple of days, as we have seen the market rise exponentially with people getting on the game and stuff like that. So that is one thing that I wanted to put that seed out there, right, and start talking about it today. We're going to talk about it more tomorrow, but if you did want to take the coins on some cards, be my guest, as a lot of these cards have risen up a ton even more. Again, you have more cards going extinct. Now, we haven't had any price range updates today except for Benjamin Mendy's card. And, you know, we're going to keep an eye on this because since we've had these cards go extinct, I would expect to see price ranges again probably happen Wednesday night tonight or into Thursday, because I do believe I was looking back towards last year at the beginning of FIFA 21, and there were two price range updates that happened on the game before the full game release. So I would expect one more set of price range updates to happen on guys like Renato, Kempembe, Dembele, Hakimi, Teo Hernandez, even guys like De Jong, right? De Jong Was like 125,000 coins. He's 119 right now, but his max is 130. So there's a lot of cards that are getting very close to their max price range. Some cards, not a lot, but some cards are getting close to their max price range. And that's something to kind of keep an eye out for. So again, if you're trying to trade on this market and make coins like I am, position change and chemistry style trading and trading with icons is definitely a place to go, especially with SBC solutions. Everything that we talked about in the best trading methods video from just a couple days ago is still working 100% on this game. And you know, it's just, there's so many ways to trade right now on the game that it is just fantastic. And there's lots of ways to make coins, which makes it very fun. So that is kind of, I guess, a little bit of a market watch, market update for you guys and what is going on right now in this game. So that is the video for today, boys. If you did enjoy it, make sure to leave a thumbs up, comment down below if you have any questions, and subscribe if you're new. It's been Nate the Foot Accountant. I will catch you guys later. Peace.